What's up, beautiful people? Corwin L. Gilliams here from CLG Lifestyle. Hope you guys are feeling blessed. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to support the platform. CLG Lifestyle is all about influencing you to love self, wherever you are, if you're starting from the ground up. Just what you would call in this season a lifestyle recorder or journalist, in that I am being open to basically just being transparent with you guys about my journey, moving from New York City to California on my own, driving cross country during the pandemic. And you know, it's 2020. This was in 2020, spring 2020, and then now in 2024, so much has happened. I'm still in California working towards accomplishing my goals and my dreams, trusting God in the process, desiring God's plans for my life overall. And I've been desiring to take my online community on this journey with me in a more transparent way. You know, I don't mind talking like on a podcast or behind the scenes. So, you know, being in front of the camera, it's a little weird to me, but as they say, you know, consistency, repetition, determination, you know, you'll be able to do things more confidently and more assuredly. So with that being said, I love to see when people grow, right? You can look back at some people's platforms and you can say, wow, I can see the transformation, I can see the growth. So that's essentially what this is going to be like. Ultimately, if you are rocking with me, or if you may go away and then come back, you'll be able to see my growth, and it should inspire you alternatively, right? The goal is to be an inspiration, to be a motivator, to be a positive influence in the lives of those who choose to subscribe or who is led to my platform. So in alignment with being more transparent, I wanted to talk about, you know, the educational development on my path and what I've been doing in regards to that. So right now I am currently going to school at the Los Angeles Film School. I am completing a bachelor's degree in entertainment business. This bachelor's degree is something that has been long awaited. It is something that I've been striving after for a while, but for whatever reasons, since my graduation from a community college in 2011, I believe, was it 2014, I've attempted to continue and complete a bachelor's, but for whatever reasons, it's always been something in the way. But in this season now, I believe that I am ready. Actually, later on today, I have to catch up on some work. So my anticipated graduation, according to documents, is August 2025. But I'm hoping for a more immediate or sooner graduation, preferably June. But we'll see what happens. And so after that, the plan is for grad school is to complete a JD. And so this is where I believe most of, when it comes to the educational or academic endeavors of what it is that CLG Lifestyle does, that I'll be creating more content revolved around an unconventional path into law school. And so if this is something that interests you, if this is something that, you know, excites you, definitely stay tuned for that. So real quick, in the state of California, which most of us know, or a lot of people know, California has always been known to be a progressive state in a lot of things, but more particularly when it comes to the traditional path of becoming an attorney or a licensed attorney or a lawyer. You don't necessarily have to practice law if you go to law school. A lot of people pursue a JD simply as an educational milestone, simply as a learning opportunity to expand their mind, expand their horizons, to get into certain rooms. They don't necessarily graduate, sit for the bar, and become an attorney. So it all depends on what it is that you want to do, what are your goals, what are your plans. And so for me, what I do as the digital publishing and the brand, right, is to, again, expand my horizons, get the knowledge, get the information, because in the long run, when it comes to owning a business that makes a certain amount of money, or having a business that employs a certain amount of employees, or wanting to have different endeavors and ventures, right, it makes sense that, you know, you continuously learn, and you learn what has been proven according to wisdom and insight to help sustain the ideas and the ventures that you are pursuing, but also the community involved with, you know, your industry or your profession, right? So again, it comes back to you making a decision that's right for you and becoming unapologetic and uncompromising about it, but yet still being willing to pivot, right, if you need to. So I think my screen is a little blurry, sorry about that. So I'll be creating, so traditionally, for those who don't know, when it comes to pursuing a JD, you have to have, traditionally, right, I understand now that there are pathways into a JD program, an official JD program, but typically it's you having a bachelor's degree, having to take the LSAT. The LSAT is a standardized test that is required per ABA Law School Administration or Admissions requirement that you need to take. And depending on your score, you know, highest being, I believe, a 180, the lows being like 140s and less, depending on your score, in addition to your GPA and other qualifying information, such as, let's say you're a traditional student in that you went from high school, did your SATs, volunteering, then straight out of high school, you went to college, then now you're in grad school, they'll consider qualifying information as part of your application to determine if you are the right fit, depending on what school you're gonna go to, right? That's the traditional path. Now they've included the GRE, which has been typically it is a grad school standardized test, but it's not specifically for law school. It's just for the most part, any grad school that you want to go to, this standardized test is just to assess your ability to do the work, right, in grad school, and to assess that if you did complete your bachelor's degree, that you learned something that you have taken with you, and you can apply to the quiz or the exams and the questions that's in the GRE. Now, law schools are requiring GRE as another option in addition to the LSAT, right? So now this is where I come in, right? The unconventional path, right? So those of you who do not have a bachelor's degree, you may have an associate's or 60 credits towards a bachelor's. You have the opportunity to go to law school at a state-accredited law school. In other words, in the state of California, in the jurisdiction of California, the State Bar Committee, which is the committee who formalizes the state bar exams and basically institutes like rules and regulations and ethics when it comes to governing the body of legal professionals in the state of California. So that includes, of course, administering the bar exam, administering discipline if legal professionals are needing to be disciplined or corrected, you know, because of ethical reasons or complaints, in addition to creating opportunities that will increase the equity and inclusion of certain demographics within the legal field. This is specifically within the jurisdiction of California, right? So with that being said, they have provided opportunities for people who would not have typically gotten into law school in a traditional way to get into law school in an untraditional way. So one of the paths, as I mentioned before, is to have 60 plus credits or an associate's degree. And it is not required for you to take the LSAT, okay? So you, on top of having, you know, recommendations, your transcripts, and your personal letter or your personal statement as to why you want to pursue a law degree or why you want to be a lawyer, you know, etc., etc. So there are about 17, last time I checked, 17 institutions dispersed throughout the state, north, south, inland, right, that will consider your application, granted that you've submitted all the requiring documents, and assess if this is the right school for you, and you both agree, and you say, okay, yes. So I'm going to be curating and just collecting information about these schools and then presenting them to you guys in a way that I believe will be encouraging and motivating for you to make a decision so that you can get on the path of accomplishing possibly a long-awaited dream, accomplishing a dream that you didn't think was possible because of where you live, having the traditional requirements to accomplish such a goal. Now you're having the information to know that it is possible. You may have to relocate, or you may not. Some of these institutions provide online pathways or hybrid pathways where you can do both on campus and online, or 100% online. It all depends on what it is that you're trying to accomplish and what fits you best. So if that resonates, definitely stay connected. And I'm back at the house now, so I'm gonna end this video, but stay tuned. I'll be creating more content revolved around this and just my journey overall. Okay, talk to y'all soon.